Hey guys, it's TownieSimBuilds here, and welcome back to another bite-sized speed build. Now, this build has been in the works for quite a while, and I think you guys might have seen it in my community tab poll. But yes, here we are. We are finally doing the mini speed build for the Sorcerer's Tower. So this was a really fun build. I think I originally started working on this probably a good month or so ago, so it was kind of on the back burner. I think I got most of the outside shell done first, but yeah, I was kind of losing steam. I was kind of losing the inspiration for this build. But as of lately, I actually started watching the show Once Upon a Time, and I've honestly been enjoying it so much, and it really gave me the push I needed to finally complete this build. But anyways, we are in the world of cottage living, which is Henford-on-Bagley, and originally I was really inspired for this build. I was looking at the tower from 𝗧𝗎𝗇𝗎, if you guys are familiar with Kingdom Hearts. And of course, I was also looking at Rapunzel's tower from Disney's Tangled. So those two were clearly the main inspirations here. And I thought it would be a really cool idea to make a tiny home for a sorcerer or wizard, if you will. So I do believe this falls in the tier 3 category. It's definitely less than 100 tiles. I think the screen is showing 74, so well within that limit. And originally I did want a 3-story tower and then some kind of little bump out on the left. Now obviously I don't really know how architecturally sound it is, but you know what? This is a sorcerer's tower. We can use a little bit of magic to defy physics. So that is what we have here. But anyways, the tower itself is made out of stone. And I used a lot of different plants and flowers and bits of ivy to really make this lot overgrown. Most of the windows you see are also from the Cottage Living pack, just to fit the look. And I'm also creating these staircases now. I gave it a little bit of elevation, and yeah, as you can see, there was a little bit of troubleshooting with the stairs, but I did finally get them in place. Now you will see in a little bit, I will also be creating a little bit of a river or moat around the tower itself. So it's not quite like a medieval tower, but I thought it was a nice natural element to have. I also use a lot of these pink mushrooms originally from Debug, and I do believe these are from the Realm of Magic pack. So really trying to create something out of a fairy tale here. I do also use the cottage living fences that I probably overused quite a bit on these rustic builds, but they work great. And originally I was going to use the debug fences originally from Get Together, or yeah, I think it's the Get Together debug fence pieces as well. But as you guys know, if you guys do not work with the tool mod, things just don't really snap to the terrain very well. So unfortunately I had to go back to the regular fence, but we do use more debug cottage living trees as well. Just plopping in some more flowers near the mailbox area. And eventually I do also use these really cool lanterns from the cottage living pack as well. So just as a quick note, this whole lot is made for the off-grid challenge. So if you guys like playing like that, if you guys like playing on lots that are off-grid, maybe are a little bit more historical, obviously not using any electricity or power, I think this lot is perfect for this. I imagine this sorcerer probably lived in the era of the Renaissance, if I was going to make some kind of educated guess, I'd say. Anyways, we're going back in and making the final touches to the tower itself. I'm using these, I believe they're called corbels, from the cottage living pack, just to add a little bit of a design accent, a little bit of support, and then just adding in these very quick base game planter boxes as well. I was honestly going to town with these plants everywhere, so I thought it fit the look. And finally using these pseudo or faux dormers from the cottage living pack. Now I will say, there's going to be a few windows on the walls. You guys can see I'm using the very small window option from cottage living, but I do get rid of a lot of those because the floor plan was interesting. We're going to leave it at that. The floor plan was interesting and it took a little bit of experimenting. But anyways, we are completing the outside with these very giant rock pieces from the Realm of Magic pack. So I definitely wanted to give this a very fantastical feel. And like I said, if you don't have tool, placing these kinds of objects is a pain in the butt. They don't situate properly. Usually they kind of ride the terrain. But thankfully these Realm of Magic rocks definitely did the trick. They were definitely situating in the terrain enough so that the main effect, the end result, I should say, was more or less believable. But here I am, I'm just completing this area with some ivy and some flowers just to fill in those awkward gaps. And we're currently working on the first floor of the tower. Now, originally, I actually had to scrap this whole thing. I was doing a sort of a mudroom area, you know, a place to take off your shoes, hang your coat. But I realized I had no room for a kitchen. So I did create a little kitchenette here. Unfortunately, there was not room for a counter. So good luck. You know, good luck if your Sims are creating more complex dishes. But I think the sorcerer or wizard living here is more than capable. I do know that spellcasters can create their own food, so I thought canonically in my head, there's not really a big issue if we don't have all the appliances here. So, you know what, that is the lore I'm going for, and I'm going to stick with that. But even still, I did want to create a very cozy rustic kitchen. I do use a lot more cottage living, and I do use the Realm of Magic oven as well. Herbs are also a very big part of this build. I do include them everywhere. So we have some over the sink. We will have some later next to the main entryway as well. And then I found these really interesting, I believe they're either debug objects or hidden objects. And they're all kinds of weird animals or creatures in little jars. Yes. I don't really know what they're supposed to be. This may be part of the collectible system in The Sims. But you know, if we're brewing potions, I thought they were absolutely perfect. So I do use those. And I also made use of the foliage bits, I guess I'd call them, from the Cottage Living pack. They sort of look like grapevines, but I do reuse them quite a bit. So I do like having a lot of those whimsical sort of ivy natural elements everywhere. So you will see them in some areas. Anyways, we're going to the next floor, and this is the very tight squeeze bathroom. What I did is I actually made a wall, and I used the wood paneling from the Get Together pack, almost as if this area was sort of walled off into a bathroom. Like I said, everything here is off-grid, so you don't need any power or electricity, so that is a really cool benefit. And I did finally get to use a lot more of the Realm of Magic torches or candelabras. I'm not really sure what you call them. They're supposed to be floor lamps, but I do think they are a little bit more ethereal. But you will see them here and there. Anyways, the little bump out of the tower that does have an outdoor walkway does lead to the sorcerer's bedroom. And I completely neglected to talk about the sorcerer, but this sorcerer is very fun. I imagine they're a little bit more eclectic. They're definitely a little bit more scatterbrained and messy. So I did include a lot of little objects here and there. For the most part, I think this sorcerer is very well researched. They love learning new spells, but on that note, they're just books. There are tomes everywhere, different ingredients in jars, lots of different flowers and herbs everywhere. So that was kind of the vibe I was going for. That was kind of the personality I was envisioning in my head when I was doing this. Anyways, we're just finishing off the little hallway area. These areas, guys, they're always hard because at the end of the day, there is so little space to work with. And I still have to playtest this. I still have to playtest this build because routing issues are a very big concern. But I did want to leave enough space so Sims hopefully would not get stuck. Anyways, we're moving on to the last floor of the tower. And this is the topmost floor featuring the main study area. So this will be where the wizard is primarily setting up their cauldron, maybe experimenting with some different elixirs perhaps, making all sorts of potions. It's sort of a library and research area, if you will. It kind of serves a lot of different purposes. But as you guys saw, I did have to delete some windows to make way for the Realm of Magic bookcases, which I always love but very rarely get to use. And like I said, this is a very studious but very messy wizard or sorcerer. So a lot of their books and tomes are everywhere. But I did squeeze in this very large cabinet. So we could include some of the potions, again pulled from debug. I do use another sort of higher bar table for more clutter. And then also a base game accent table there as well. So this area is probably where they're doing some of their note-taking. This could be a spell book, albeit the book is very simple looking, but I do think it passes nonetheless. Just kind of alt-shift placing some potions and a teapot in place there. And I totally forgot to include a familiar. So for this wizard, for this sorcerer, I end up choosing the leaf bat, I think? the leaf bat familiar, if you will. I thought it fit the quirky nature of the wizard and sort of the very natural, overgrown, whimsical look, so I thought that was a suitable choice. Anyway, circling back over here next to the cabinet, I did want to create a little sitting area here. So there is an armchair, there is a torch there from Realm of Magic. And just going in now with more of these weird jars. Maybe there is a spider, eye of newt, frog legs, you know, all the classic fantasy ingredients. So that is what I'm going with. Just some final clutter in the corner there. And finishing off the room now with the cream curtains. And I do believe they are the same ones I used in the bedroom itself. All right, guys, and that is a wrap on the Sorcerer's Tower in the world of Henford-on-Bagley. Now, if you guys were waiting on this build for a little while, I do hope you guys enjoyed the end result. And if you enjoy more occult builds, I do certainly have more stuff for spellcasters, but also for mermaids, vampires, ghosts, maybe even aliens as well. So please feel free to share your ideas in the comments. With that said, I will leave you guys with the final cinematic shots of the build, along with the final lot specs as well. Just like always, this has been TownieSimBuilds, signing off. Thank you so much for watching, guys.